This is Bob.
Hey, Bob.
Stop that. This is not an AA meeting. Bob is a worker at the solar power plant. Bob busts his ass 6 days a week at his job and saves his money instead of blowing it on stupid books with bad arguments and gas for Molotov cocktails because he's not an idiot. Bob saves thousands of dollars and buys a server rig with all the bells and whistles and a really fast internet with all the best kinds of tubes, and he has some money left over to hire two people to run it. Bob has this really cool idea for a website and server that'll let people play a stupid game with each other better than anybody else. Problem is, he doesn't know how to work the fucking thing. He only knows how to turn the knobs at the solar power plant, but he did learn a little bit of investing and accounting online. Bob hires Kropotkin. Kropotkin is a dick, but this dick knows how to program. He also hires Bakunin, who is also a total asshole. An asshole that knows networking. He pays him a wage to get the website and server running. But there's a problem. Kropotkin and Bakunin are exploiting Bob's capital investment. You see, while they made labor on his machine, it wasn't nearly as much labor that went into getting the server and the internets in the first place. If they didn't do it, Bob's investment would diminish as technology would surpass his investment, making it worthless. And Bob would starve with the extra bills to keep it running while he learned how to figure it out and would end up failing and starving before it happened because it could take years for one person to learn how to do all of that shit. It's slavery, you see. Because without those two, Bob would not only starve trying to figure out what to do with that hunk of metal and that fast web zones, but he would also have suffered by saving his money on that machine rather than going to see Noam Chomsky pretend to know about foreign policy. Ah, but he could just hire someone else, right? Well, he could, but wouldn't that be just the same as saying that you can go and find another job if you don't like your job in a capitalist system? Being free to choose someone else to exploit your capital isn't exactly a choice now, is it? In the end, he would still end up having to hire someone because he wouldn't be able to figure it out by himself. Herein lies the problem with the wage slavery argument. It's stupid. It can be used in the other way around because it's not a practical philosophy at all. While even if you could demonstrate that there's a theoretical ethical problem with it, it could also be the most beneficial social arrangement for all parties involved at the same time. I'm perfectly fine with being exploited by a capitalist given the alternative social structures provided by the left. Worms.